Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed an honor for me to join this distinguished panel along with Mr. Brahim Asanu and the rest of the distinguished panelists we have today, addressing a very important topic and an issue that used to be in the past a sectoral one, but now is touching everything that we are about to tackle, not just in the industry, but in our life. And we see it from the World Bank Group perspective that the topic of choice today is extremely relevant, timely, and much needed for better understanding on what we can do going forward, how to strike a balance between protection of rights and harnessing innovation and advances in artificial intelligence, the Internet of Things, and cyber security. Recently, the world of international development has witnessed and undergoing a sea change of disruption driven by advances in technology and innovation. For us at the World Bank Group, we are attempting to harness these disruptive elements as means not only to achieve our twin goals of reducing extreme poverty and promoting shared prosperity, but also to the accomplishment of the sustainable development goals by 2030. The promise of these disruptive advances in technology and innovation is also carrying with them certain risks, as mentioned by the previous speakers, including exposing data of individuals and institutions to compromise pressure or rights. The ecosystem that promotes the use and advantages of new technologies, as well as the trust of users in these technologies, is supported by multiple stakeholders from public, private sector, NGOs, civil society, and academia. And the World Bank has been very much involved in technology for development for quite some time now. Our latest three flagship world development reports all focused on the impact of technology on development. The World Development Report of 2016, titled Digital Dividends, examined the development realities of the digital world in which we live. The 2017 World Development Report focused on learning how to realize education promise and investigating the role of education in building human capital. And most recently, the current World Development Report analyzes the changes in the nature of work due to technological advances. The World Bank recognized very quickly that the impact of all of these technological advances were not going to translate automatically into positive development outcomes, and that there are needs to bring together the various units in our organization to discuss, analyze the potential implications on different countries. We created the Technology and Innovation Lab. We created as well a Disruptive Technologies Network, in addition to other platforms to get us in a better position in partnership with external players from the public and the private sector to promote our technical and financial assistance to countries. We work basically in three pillars. They are the three B's of build, boost, and brokering. The first pillar, which is called build, under which we seek to develop the foundational building blocks for sustainable technology-enabled economies. The second pillar is called boost, under which we seek to expand the capacity of people and institutions to thrive in a resilient society. And finally, under brokering, we seek to harness disruptive technology, data, and expertise to solve development challenges and manage risks. Let me emphasize that while we are taking matters related to partnerships and investment in technology and innovation, we are trying our best as well in partnership with governments to enhance the investment in human capital. Governments in pursuit of economic growth love to invest in fiscal capital. And here I'm quoting from the introductory remarks of the President of the World Bank in a recent article in Foreign Affairs. And he mentioned as well that this kind of love in investment goes into building roads, beautiful bridges, gleaming airports, and other infrastructure. But they are typically far less interested in investing in human capital, which is the sum total of population health, skills, knowledge, experience, and habits. Such a neglect of human capital will complicate any kind of serious attention and support to the advances in technology and maximize their impact on development. In order to bridge gaps, we are developing a new project, which is the Human Capital Project, with an index to measure the capacity of countries in enhancing human capital. The new measurements will encourage countries to invest in health and education, and with a fierce sense of urgency. That will help, we hope, to prepare everyone to compete and thrive in the economy of the future, whatever they may turn out to be. And it will help make the global system work for everyone. Failing to make those investments would simply be too costly to human progress and human solidarity. And here I'm ending the quote of the work of the President of the World Bank in the article I referred to. And for that, and for the seriousness of the task ahead of us all, we appreciate the invitation of the World Bank to be part of the discussion with you during this important symposium. Thank you very much.